my first time, anyway. I'm Mark Isaacs, as you probably know, and I've got a program for you which I called New Standards, because I always loved the idea of jazz standards was taking a popular tune and working with it. I bring my jazz and classical background to it. But I noticed the standards normally were the popular tunes of, for my age, my parents' generation, tunes from the 30s, 40s, 50s, say. But tonight I'm going to play songs from my youth, which is pop music from the 60s and 70s. So you just heard from the Beatles or Paul McCartney's song, The Fool on the Hill. So then, continuing from that period, I'm going to take a composition by a man who unfortunately left us earlier this year, Mr. Burt Bacharach, beautiful songwriter. And this is called, fittingly, always was, always will be, fittingly, what the world needs now is love. Thank you. a nice time to ask if you will silence your mobile phones?
I did have it on silent.
Oh, yeah, it sounds like it.
To YouTube or something. Sorry.
Doesn't matter. It's a very nice piece of
music.
That's perfectly fine. Actually, if I could ask that nobody hold up their mobile phones, too, a couple of people did, and I understand, but it actually distracts me. So. Okay, now I forgot what I was going to play. I'm not going to play for Elise, because you've already played it for me. The last song for this set, I'm playing two sets for you, was written by a woman who I would call a poet. She's a songwriter, she's a singer, she picks up a guitar. She's been around, I think some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. And this is a beautiful song by Joni Mitchell.
Thank you.
similar ilk. Thank you again for coming. I have CDs at the back there. A solo piano, not this music. I haven't released this music yet. Some original compositions of mine, marrying classical music and jazz. So if you're interested, and after the show, I'll be hanging out in here and really look forward to talking to you all and meeting you, those who haven't met already, that is, and seeing again those that I have. Thank you very much. See you soon.
Thank you.
some of you knew know that song. I really love it. It first came out in 1980, sung by Randy Crawford. Randy Crawford, wonderful African American singer, and it was written by Joe Sample, who was the pianist in the Jazz Crusaders. One of the first few jazz fusion bands I heard. I left home about 19. I was playing this recording called Free as the Wind. It's on Spotify, I'm sure. Jazz, just sort of like jazz players would play, you know, play funky, you know, but beautiful jazz chords over it. And Joe was the pianist in that. He wrote this song, Randy Crawford, recorded in 1980, but it had another emergence. Some of you might remember in 2001, there was a film called Moulin Rouge, and Nicole Kidman sang this song, One Day I'll Fly Away, and she sang beautifully. She's got a beautiful voice. She ran up in a beautiful gown to the top of a tower and belted it out. It was almost sort of semi-operatic. Really great song. Although I think he stole it consciously, not it, but just the opening bit of it, unconsciously perhaps, from Tchaikovsky, because it goes... Subconscious, that's how, you know, everything's out there. Something I noticed a while back. So going back to these the 60s and 70s, there was popular music. There's also two musical films that came out that were very iconic, for me anyway, as a small boy in the early 60s, maybe mid-60s. And I think they resonated with other generations since. One of them was Mary Poppins. The other one was The Sound of Music. Yeah. So this is one of the songs from that which you will recognize, maybe not immediately, because that's what I do. Thank you. behind me. If you want a little something else after this, I've got a couple of things in mind.
Yes.
Yes,
but
please.
Yes. I mean, you're not supposed to announce your encore. Play them, but I didn't want you to get worried that it was all going to finish too soon. Although I should be able to go for a while on this one. Another of the crazes, musical crazes of the 60s, I remember, was the bossa nova craze. Beautiful marriage of Brazilian rhythm with the Portuguese language, which they speak in Brazil, and harmony reminiscent of Chopin, probably, really. That's my analysis, anyway. And this is probably the most famous of those bossa nova melodies. I won't even announce it. You'll recognize it again fairly soon. And a beautiful singer, Astrid Gilbert, who sang it, died this year. No, I'd like to mention Burt Bacharach passed, and Astrid did also this year. So it's nice in memory of people, keep them alive.
Thank you.
Thank you.
promise you a little bit more. Would you like?
Yes!
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Something short and sweet. So this group is Simon and Garfunkel, the songwriter is Paul Simon. Jazz venue in Sydney where everyone would shoot out immediately. It was terrible. It was very sad. Everybody was rushing out. There was in a theatre and there was overtime considerations and they were just like, go, and, but no, I'll go for a minute and I'll come out and see you. Thank you so much for your listening.